What's going on, everybody? There's a new Keeper of Secrets confirmed, and I'm hoping this saves me in AOS 2. Now, Slaanesh, I hold deep in my heart as my true love of all the four Chaos Gods, probably pun intended. My favorite models from them were always the big clawed demonettes, and they confirmed the new Keeper of Secrets today. And by confirmed, I mean the Sigmar Facebook page put out the Warhammer Herald, like, banner. As you know, it's like an in-world banner. And it's like, can you keep a secret? The new hottest show in town or whatever. And there's like a cartoon Keeper of Secret leg coming out from behind the curtains. Hopefully that means there's a new Keeper of Secrets. I don't know why they would not have a new one when the other three have already been redone. Now, this is very exciting, because Slaanesh is my favorite. Now, that being said, AOS 2 I do not think is very good. It is just, maybe it's, well, it's probably me. A lot of people are enjoying it, but there's a lot of things they did and added that they thought were making the game better, like stacking command abilities and just massive amounts of dice coming out of things and price discounts for, you know, overpowered troop units, like, I don't know, extra artifacts that are just better than most people's artifacts in their books, spells that are insane. It feels like it's in a bad place to me. And summoning, the free summoning is awful, just miserably bad. And the Slaanesh in the General's Handbook have a summoning mechanic, so I'm not looking forward to that at all if they get a book that comes out and they stick with that, which they probably will. That being said, I'm hoping Slaanesh, my true love of an army, saves me in my love for AOS, which is very, very low right now. I think 40k is in a much better spot. I'm not much of a competitive player either, so don't worry about that. I'm not saying about the tournaments and stuff. But AOS seems to have very clear, if you're this book, you need to play this army kind of situations, like, or there'll be two because the formations or battalions, there'll only be one or two good ones in the books. And not only are they the only good ones, they're really good compared to the other ones that are almost completely pointless. I think a lot of people that play Age of Sigmar competitively just maybe ignore the fact that, like, the Daughters of Cain and the Gashalists are pretty much the entire top of the thing every single time they try to, like, get excited when something else creeps up there, but it's just, it's the same over and over again. That being said, I have not played an AOS tournament, but with my love for Slaanesh, that also brings the joy of maybe bringing them over to 40k. I do have the Chaos Demon Codex, and of course that would mean the possibility of the Emperor's Children book coming out for 40k, depending on if they have a new marine kit for Slaanesh coming out, something along those lines. Very possible, especially they got the new Noise Marine kind of re-throwback. So, although it does seem unlikely that with the throwback Noise Marine they would then release the brand new Noise Marine kit, but it's possible, so I don't know. That all being said as well, the AOS 2 has, well, let me rephrase that. I have a lot of money on the line for my Kickstarter. The paintbrushes that I'm going to be launching, I've still been using them almost exclusively since I got my one set of 8 test set, and they've been going really well. I paint quite a bit. I do switch over to some real sharp Kalinske sables when I need to do fine lines, but pretty much everything else, I've been using them, and I'll use cheaper brushes when I'm using, like, wash or metallics. I haven't really used them for metallics and stuff, but I have a lot of money on the line, and whenever that is, and the money's on the line regardless of the success of Kickstarter, so that is puts you in that mindset where what's important to you, then you have to start balancing that, right? Slaanesh is the god of excess. And I have too much stuff. So I decided the Skaven are on the chopping block. They're gone. The models are too old and crappy. Some of them have a lot of character and stuff. But if they're gonna win me over with Skaven, they're gonna need a new line of models. And not like a regrouping, like a Beast of Chaos book, or I mean, potentially the new Night Goblin book is gonna have like some new units, but then still use the old Night Goblins. I don't think they can do that with Skaven. A lot of the models are just too outdated. A lot of them are metal. I'm also gonna be getting rid of. So the Skaven are gone. I'm selling them on eBay. If you want the Clan Skyer, I got Jezails and machine gunners and the Poison Globe guys and all kinds of stuff going up. Pestilence stuff. I got a whole big army of Pestilence stuff I'll be putting up. So just keep clicking the link below to my eBay store if you want to check out any of the Skaven stuff I'm getting rid of. And that's unfortunate because in AOS 1 with General's Handbook 1, I bought up like tons of armies and I like playing all of them. They were all fun. And now in AOS 2 with the General's Handbook, everything feels off to me. So that being said, I still have all my demons and Slaanesh, possibly getting a book might get me love into AOS again. The Stormcast, I still have a very small army of them, which I can do like a 2,000 point. I'm not sure if they're gonna make it through. I need to clear out space because I got a lot of paintbrushes on order, and hopefully the Kickstarter is successful, so I'll get these paintbrushes and then ship them out, right? Hopefully in some kind of reasonable time. But I will be putting up a lot of stuff for sale, purging a lot of my old metal models, probably almost all my old metal demons, now that the like bloodletter, the corn dogs and the fiends of Slaanesh, they're all new, getting new sculpts. I don't really want to buy much of that stuff right now though, just because I'm not super happy with AOS and I don't play demons only in 40K. I'm working on Deathwatch, I play Admech. But I don't think I can let Slaanesh releases pass me without buying them because I'm crack addict, plastic crack addict, not a regular crack addict. So let's hope Slaanesh saves the Red Beard for AOS 2. If not, it might be something I just collect and hold on to. And also getting rid of the excess of my collection. Armies that I might get rid of are Nurgle. I never really loved it the way. Well, like Tzeentch Korn and Slaanesh. Nurgle, I do like painting them though. So a lot of these models, because I do paint and sell models on eBay, you can check down below for my store. I mostly do D&D models, but I was thinking about it. I buy D&D models. Like, I just finally, these guys got back in stock. I buy them to paint and then I put them on eBay to sell. And then I also sell like old Warhammer stuff, little things. But it kind of makes sense that instead of just selling off a lot of my Warhammer stuff, I should paint it and then sell it if I'm doing that anyway. Instead of continually buying new things to paint and sell, I should paint and sell the things I already have. Which kind of goes to that, like, paint things before you buy new things. So I'm going to be doing a combination. I'm going to be painting things and selling them painted. That helps you practice a lot. When you don't have to repeat it 40 times, it's just a 10-man thing or a 5-man squad. And that's fun. And then also, I'll be getting rid of bulk things like metal miniatures, they're just too much of a pain. I think I'll be selling all them. And a lot of old miniatures, I don't want to sit there and clean tons of mold lines off a regiment of 20, storm vermin. But at the same time, if it was like a war. An arch warlock or a model, a character maybe in an army that catches my eye. Maybe I'll paint that and sell it painted, try to get something more from it. But that's about all I got right now. This is just a quick little announcement on the Lord of Excess, the Keeper of Secrets, coming soon. My thoughts on Slaanesh being that I love them, and they're my favorite. And the new models, oh my god, they look so good. So I hope they, I don't know. I just hope it does right, whether or not I have to use them in 40K or Sigmar. I'm thinking, I don't know. I'm really hoping for the best for them. Please subscribe. Please go down below if you want to check out my eBay store. I have links to all kinds of products that I sometimes review. All of them I use, so they're not like just, you know, buy this Mercedes and I get a commission. Which would be cool if you want to buy a Mercedes and I get a commission somehow. Let's figure how out, you know, figure out how to do that and let me know. And then also, I got the Kickstarter coming soon, so please stay tuned for that.